I'm Carmen Electra, and this is VH1's 100 Greatest Artists of Hard Rock. With a little help from our friends, VH1 has compiled the ultimate list of the very best bands and artists in that monster we call hard rock. In determining the list, writers and artists like Ozzy Osbourne and Flea chose from all the great heavy metal, punk, classic rock, and grunge artists ever. We tabulated their votes to come up with this list. Kicking things off is a band who used their hard-edge hooks and glam rock looks to become the first American heavy metal band to debut at number one.
Quiet Riot just sort of appeared out of nowhere. All of a sudden, they just blossomed into this massive rock group.
Well, every time a Quiet Riot song would come on, you knew it was Quiet Riot. It was always that, yeah, yeah, you know, almost like cheerleaders. You know, I mean, all their songs were the kind of songs where every teenager in the audience had to sing along with it.
My mama, we're all crazy now. My mama, we're all crazy now.
Very loud, very energetic. I just wanted to stand on the speaker and, like, dive into an audience.
Cultural thing for a short period of time, a microcosm of rock and roll history, Quiet Riot was the thing.
It's difficult for bands to live on a situation of being made right through doing a cover tune as Quiet Riot did. But they have the talent to live beyond that, and they're still around to this day.
Bad Brains was the first band to sort of synthesize full-out aggressive rock with sort of a Rasta dub thing.
Over the top. It's one of my favorite rock and roll records of all time.
I used to sit up in my bedroom and play drums along to that record for hours on end.
Without a drum set.
The thing about a lot of punk is that there's the feeling of, that a lot of bands have is just like apathy and hopelessness, and where Bad Brains lyrical content had a lot of hope in.
The diffusion of reggae and hardcore was pretty unprecedented. Bad Brains were one of the greatest rock and roll bands.
Completely brilliant, completely influential, and oftentimes overlooked for the contribution that they made to alternative rock.
Mountain were kind of like the original American heavy metal band.
This is typically one of those songs that no matter, I don't care who you are, you have to love that song.
There's no hard rock song which has more impact than that.
Mississippi Queen!
Oh, what a time!
around about 1970, people invariably ended up at rock clubs all over Europe, and they would always play music of the latest bands. This one night, this band came on doing Mississippi Queen, and we didn't speak to each other for about 3 minutes, because we thought, who the hell is this? They have just completely destroyed our sound. You know, Leslie West, Felix Capolari, great, great musicians, along with Corky Lane.
They're probably one of the best American three pieces that was ever around.
They held up against the British stuff, up against the Led Zeppelins and the Cream. Nobody can slow me down.
Leslie certainly taught me how to turn up my Marshall, just let it rip. Because I think that tone, that beautiful tone that Leslie had on the guitar was always, just he'd just turn the damn thing to 11 and let it fly.
I don't know what to say about him. Those guys are legends.
When the band at number 97 formed in San Francisco, it was instantly apparent that their mix of thrash, funk, and metal stood in sharp contrast to their motto, "We Suck."
Love Brian was great, fun music, you know, incredibly talented. Les Claypool on the bass, obviously. Got the whole white trash hick thing going. I dig it.
Incredible band. I think one of the first bands post-Zappa to actually use humor and wit in their music. My name is Mud. Not to think it used to be the next. My name is Mud. It's always better.
Winona's Big Beaver. That video is so bizarre.
Well, I was gonna see how Big Brown Beaver and shows them up to all her friends. When they know that beaver tried to leave it, so she came up with that girl fast.
It's like just a lab experiment that's just gone bad, in a good way.
You listen to Jerry as a race car driver. It's funny. I find the music incredibly moving while it's also kind of goofy in a way. The cortical goofiness is a mask for an incredible band.
On a hot summer night, would you offer your throat to the wolf with the red roses?
I play my Super Bowl every night when I walk on a stage. That's how I look at it. It's not another show. When I'm on stage, I can literally get people to do anything I want. And I like that, because I think that's what I'm there to do.
I can't really talk about Meatloaf without talking about Jim Steinman, who was the bleeding and battered fingers behind the whole thing.
It was just all really wild and freaky, this big fat guy with this big voice and this really weird long-haired guy pounding on the piano.
Bordering on being a musical theater as opposed to being a rock and roll show.
He just knocked me out as a performer, too. He just was tireless. You know, for such a big guy at that point in time. Very, very different from anything I ever really heard. And, man, he could sing his ass off, too. He really packed a punch with his voice. I would do anything to love anything you've been dreaming of, but I just won't do that. They were stories about all of us, too. They were very, very human. Kind of stories about, you know, getting your heart broken and, you know, stuff that was easily accessible to the human heart. You took the words right out of my mouth.
Oh, you must have been why you were pissing me. Declining the attention of the major labels, this next band refused to turn its back on the movement they helped create, the Washington, D.C. hardcore scene.
It's
for me, Fugazi has a really special place in alternative music because they've never sold out in any way, shape, or form. They've completely maintained their integrity.
Here's a band that's selling, you know, loads of records, but still holding true to their beliefs and doing it in a way where it's like telling the music industry to basically fuck off.
That really struck me at Fugazi's had sort of frenetic quality to it. They synthesized the sort of the punk energy, but sort of the balls of riffs and hard rock.
They, for a long time, had their shows for $5. I don't know if it's still $5, but the whole identifying with the fan on the street and not with the trappings of fame is something I admired and feel great.
Fugazi was really the first band to sort of fully embrace rock at an alternative level.
I think that they were the key element that made alternative rock of the 90s pretty much, you know, exist.
Fiercely independent band. I have complete respect for them because they're really the only band that I can think of that stayed independent.
Another all-star band, all-star musical band. They were one of those British bands that was just such good musicians that Americans were just bowled over by their musicianship.
Song like Roundabout and you go, okay, now I get it.
I'll be the roundabout. The words will make you out and out. I'll spend the day away. Call it morning, driving through the sun and in and out the valley.
John Anderson is such a free spirit. He sounds so free when he thinks it.
The way they put together some of those songs, were, especially in the early days, was nothing short of brilliant.
I've just always loved Yes. They've always been a favorite.
Flamboyant, soulful approach and well-schooled musicianship, Lenny Kravitz revamped 60s-style rock for a whole new generation.
I love what he does. I think he's really clever, really innovative, and does stuff that shows that he's got depth and he understands history. You know, he understands where he came from.
Hears a lot of different things, so there's not a one-sided view of music. You know, there are other elements and other influences, so that's really a good thing.
I write what I feel, and I think that music is the place where I really can express my feelings.
He too is an artist in the true sense that he's going to wear his emotions on his sleeve. And I think that he's also got the courage to write from his convictions.
Ultimately, Lenny's retro stylings would earn legions of fans and push him to the forefront of hard rock in the new millennium.
It's only the beginning for me now. I feel more open now than I ever have. And
I look forward to experiencing the rest of my journey. It's about to get funky.
In the world of heavy metal, it used to be that a band's greatest challenge wasn't getting signed, but finding a woman sexy enough to get their videos noticed. Thousands of viewers logged on to VH1.com to vote for the hottest video vixens in all of hard rock. Here's what they had to say. At number 92 on our list is a band whose dedication to the blues helped keep guitar rock alive in an era when pop ruled the charts.
The Black Crowes are one of the bands that came out around the time that Guns N' Roses was just peaking. There weren't too many, you know, five-piece, just guitar, bass, drums, and vocals kind of bands around.
They came out in the early 90s when Seattle, which was, you know, ruling music basically, and then you had this just straight up rock and roll band that sounded like an old English band from the 70s.
They were sort of an American Rolling Stones band. Great blues, rock, kind of out of time.
At that time period when they came out, everybody was recording too cleanly, and along comes Black Crowes and like a bull in a china shop, and it's like, you know, all over the place. It's beautiful.
Baby, let me light your candle coals, and mama, I'm sure all the henna nag is around.
As far as a modern day blues band goes, who's better?
They're still just one of those bands that does what they do and do it well, and they do it with heart. They still have, for the most part, the same original sound they always started with, and that was against the grain to begin with.
I'm not trying to keep up with anyone or trends or anything. I'm trying to do exactly how I feel. I want my expression to be total and honest. And I think that's the band.
Misfits rule.
I was kind of one of those people in the audience going,
weird makeup, weird hairdos. I like bands that look weird.
They look like something from a Stephen King novel.
So I was like, now what is this?
The guy behind the Misfits was Glenn Danzig. We were just in awe of this guy. He was just responsible pretty much for the whole package. And then he came out with Danzig. Hard rock thing as opposed to punk rock thing that the Misfits were doing.
Somehow he was able to retain that dark, kind of creepy, sweaty, muscly thing. You know, they were always having to be all buff and all sweaty.
We're heading to Vegas in this van, and we're driving through LA somewhere, and I went, check that house out. There's this house, it's all black and gray, the trees aren't that in the yard, there's no grass going on, that stands and scrap. I'm like, nah, get out of here. But yeah, sweet.
I always enjoyed his vocals. He had quite a unique style, kind of a heavy Elvis, I'd call him. He could just belt him out.
I got a dirty black summer. Yeah, my dirty black summer.
He's so spooky and so evil. You know, you gotta love him. You have to also have to watch what you say to him, also he'll give you a look like he's gonna tear your head off.
Hey!
Caribbean 75, I think it was, because I wanted to form a little band and start the whole procedure over again, which is what I did with Vanga.
Best musicians, because of Colin Burns, he just did everything right, and so did Richie. I absolutely idolized Blackmore's playing. They had the best singers. Joe and Turner. Graham Bonnet. Ronnie James Dio, God love him, the man can sing like you've never heard anybody sing.
Rainbow were the hugest thing. I mean, Rainbow Rising is one of the great hard rock records of the 70s, absolutely.
A lot of other bands have been able to make so many great records. We've been able to paint such a beautiful painting with the most amazing colors. I'm ready.
Rita's a very tough girl. She helped to dissolve the facade that girls were just soft little fluffy critters that would do anything to get a record contract.
And I remember hanging out with her one day and saying, you know, Rita, you're really good. You can really play. You don't got to go with the sex angle. She said, yeah. The next time I see Lita, she's on all fours licking an ice cube. So much for Dee's pep talk backstage.
Her 1988 self-titled album, Lita, which included help from Motorhead's Lemmy and heavy metal madman Ozzy Osbourne, earned the Foxy frontwoman platinum status. If I close my eyes forever, will it all remain the same?
People say to me, girls don't play guitar like that. F*** you. I was born with piss and vinegar running through my f***ing veins. And I take it out on rock and roll.
The next band on our countdown lives by one rule. Artists should be heard and not seen.
Tool, they're kind of weird, you know, but they make great music.
If Tool was to walk into this room now, you wouldn't know. They don't want their pictures in the papers. They don't want to be seen in videos. That's not important to them. They feel that the only thing that is important, that's relevant, is the music.
Seeing them in performance, it was like watching the Beast from 20,000 Fathoms or something.
I think Maynard's got an incredible voice. I think he can really sing well.
More influenced right now by Tool than anything else out there available today. That's the kind of music that really influences me.
Really incredible sense of movement. I think the band's one of the greatest.
You can't pin them down. You can't say that they're this kind of band or that kind of band. You can't put a label on them.
they're like the best musicians out there. I love Tool.
Tool is just a great, great band.
King Crimson, yeah, very heavy, intellectual band. Musicianship extraordinaire. Every player was incredible.
21st Century Schizoid Man. Such a great, great song. Just raw energy.
First time I heard 20th Century Schizoid Man, I couldn't believe it. And I said, guys, here's one of the new supergroups of all time.
Robert Fripp is another unique personality. I appreciate the fact that he's more interested in making music that he's never heard than in making music that sounds comfortable and familiar.
We all knew that something was going on, but we didn't quite know why it was going on. There was just nothing we could do. It could go wrong. Music leant over and took us into its confidence. The first and foremost spirit is the music. I think that's why they're still around and they're still going, is because the music is really what counts.
I like it!
Great, great Spirit of Rock songs. Blues Pipe, amazing. Double Vision.
Double Vision.
Learned all about that real
Blue
quick.
Monday. All that stuff. It's just a great band.
American dream like many foreigners in New York City.
Pipe, you know.
Foreigner's brand of progressive rock proved to be a winning formula. With album sales exceeding the 30 million mark, their music remains a hard rock staple.
When it comes to heavy metal success in the 80s, our next band had all the key ingredients. A curly blonde frontman and a power riff repertoire. Not to mention Tawny Kitaen.
I want it all!
White Snake's all about passion, emotion, physical drama. You know, but there's a lot of tongue-in-cheek.
Paying no attention to skeptical critics, Whitesnake was on a dash at the top of the U.S. charts from the get-go.
I'll never forget something David said to me. I ain't intimidated by anybody. I don't give a damn what any of them think, because ain't nobody stronger than me.
I love David Coverdale's voice. He's a very movie singer. I like Wick. You know, nobody even talks about singing anymore.
You know, the song is very, very reminiscent of Zeppelin with a heavier edge, maybe, and just fun to listen to in the still of the night.
UFO, that's an interesting band. They kind of represent the roots of English blues-based rock.
They were like a classic example of a hard-working European band that just toured constantly and put out like a record every year.
The mostly British band UFO featured German guitarist Michael Schenker. Brother to Rudolf Schenker of the Scorpions, Michael's bluesy style stood out among the best of players.
Most hard rock guitar players will say that if it wasn't Eddie Van Halen, you know, the blah, 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 all this type of stuff, then most of the guys that were really into the more blues-based stuff, it was always Michael Schenker.
Michael Schenker is one of the best guitarists, I think, on the planet.
I was on a quest to, like, play every single Michael Schenker solo.
Michael Schenker, yeah.
They made brilliant records like Lights Out and Obsession and the live album. I mean, they're all rock classics.
UFO just really have a place in the soundtrack of my life.
They're an amazing band that have a lot of heavy riffs, a lot of melody, and to this day, I put on all those early UFO albums and just rock out. So much that my wife knows all the UFO songs now.
things like incredible band music. They have this heaviness to their sound, but incredibly melodic.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music. Over my head, it's loud and clear. Going to my head.
Three friends from Missouri, Doug Pinnock, Ty Tabor, and Jerry Gaskill, moved their act to Houston, Texas in 1985. Dubbed it King's X. Not only did they turn heads with their unique style, but also made some of rock's top dogs stand at attention.
I first heard them a few years ago, and I was blown away with the complicated arrangements, but they didn't take away from the melody. The singer is a fantastic singer too. I think it was in Purple, when we were looking for a singer, we actually called him up and said, would you like to join? And he said, no thanks, I have my own thing going. So we actually offered him the job.
Guys ever have an off night?
I don't think I would like to follow them on stage. They are one hell of a band.
It's love that holds it all together. I just had to let you know that it's
unbelievable musicianship, which to me is the heart of a great band.
And I feel it's only a matter of time before that band is the biggest band in the world.
Founded in 1981 in Seattle, this metal quintet left the club scene and refined its sound behind closed doors. 10 years later, their work earned them a multi-platinum payoff.
Queen's Art music was very much opus material.
Star. They were like a rock and roll opera.
It seems to be a rarity these days that you get a pure singer. Jeff brought that beautiful, pure voice that he has, again bringing another definition of metal music.
Truly, truly, really great rock and roll bands live that you'd ever want to see.
I like it when bands bring in a conceptual feel to their work and take you on a journey. Operation Mindcrime, for example, it's like making a movie out of music.
It's always an experiment with us. We just do what we do. We don't pretty much think about the consequences of our actions. We just, when it comes to music, that's what our passion is.
They brought a sophistication into their work. Queensryche were and still are a powerful band.
Unbelievable band. The Pixies are probably one of the top three most influential bands on alternative rock. People don't often think of the Pixies in terms of the grunge movement because they weren't necessarily a heavy band. All the alternative rock bands did was just sort of apply heaviness to basically what the Pixies were already doing, and that's when it sort of really started to gel.
I
I was jealous of Kim Deal for years. This is the ultimate in cool and beautiful voice.
Sense of absurdity about them that I enjoyed.
Just kind of wacky, off the wall,
things you wouldn't really expect.
They were really the first band to get it right, and another band that's been seriously overlooked for the influence that they had upon the alt-rock explosion.
Well, that wraps it up for this hour of VH1's 100 Greatest Artists of Hard Rock. There are 80 more rock monsters still to go. I'm Carmen Electra.